Very important is your, number one, is your liquidity. Alright? Number two is your solvency. And the last one is all about profitability. Alright? Profitability. Okay? So, what do you mean class of liquidity? Ability by the company to pay for your ability by the company to pay for current obligations. Plus, meaning to say, your liquidity is more what? Short term. Alright, let's go. So it is more on a short term basis. Okay? How about in terms of solvency? Kung ito class ay short term, this one is a long term. Meaning to say class, solvency is more on going concern. Ability by the company to survive, right? In a long period of time. And okay, period of time. Alright? And the last one is all about profitability. It is more on your performance. Diba? Performance of your business. No? And that's profitability. Liquidity, solvency, and profitability. So under liquidity, no, in your paper, what you will do is to compute for, of course, yung ating current ratio. Right? How do we compute for current ratio again? Current assets, right? Divided by your current liability. Okay. So what is the meaning of current ratio? Of course, you should have more current assets than current liability in order for you to pay for your current liability. Okay. Tagalog, mas malaki pa dapat ang current assets mo with your CL so that you can pay for your current obligations. Okay. By the way, class, what are your current assets? You have your cash, your account receivable, your inventories, your supplies, no? And other prepaid assets. How about your current liability? You have your accounts payable and other short-term payable. Meaning to say, if you have enough cash, you can be able to pay for your current liability. But very important also, in terms of liquidity, is what you call your asset or asset test ratio. Or tinatawag din ito, quick asset ratio. Alright, what do you mean class of quick asset ratio? Ability by the company to pay for your current obligations pero ano lang, cash plus marketable securities plus your accounts receivable only. Meaning to say, no need to have your inventory, no need to have your supplies. Why? Your cash, your short-term investment, and the account receivables are your most liquid assets. No? Sila yung madali in terms of converting to cash. Siyempre, cash na yan. No? And that will be your current liability. Okay. Okay? Because your short-term investment can become part of cash. No? 3 months na, pwede na maging cash. Especially also the account receivable, in terms of collection, you have now cash. But how about inventories? Diba usually matagal ang inventories na? It would depends on your operating cycle. Okay? Yeah. Okay. Very important also class that in terms of liquidity, under this one is what you call activity ratios. Okay? So ano to class? Number one, yung ating inventory turnover. Okay? So what do you mean class of inventory turnover? It measures your inventory in converting it to sales. Okay? Meaning to say, your inventory should be part of your cost of sales. Okay? So what is the formula? Cost of goods sold divided by your average inventory. Plus, all of this are part of your balance sheet. gagawin mo na lang, kukunin mo na lang, and then just put, and you will divide, and you will analyze. Okay? So, meaning to say, in the inventory turnover, we need to measure how many times are you, or how many times your inventory will be converted to sales. No? Because of that, after inventory turnover, you have your inventory days. No? Inventory days. Okay? Or inventory conversion period. How do we compute for inventory days? Number of days, 365 days, 360 days, divided by your inventory turnover. Ano pong sinabi ko about inventory days? During our meeting, diba? Mas sinabi ko is that it is the number of days wherein you will be converted to sales. How many days pala, sir? Okay? Ito class, the higher, the better. This one is the lower, the better. Why lower, the better? Common sense, diba? Meaning to say, days for it, it is now part of your sales. So under this one also, we have our accounts receivable turnover. Now, how do we compute for AR turnover? That will be your net sales divided by your average accounts receivable. Okay. Plus, what do you mean of AR turnover? This is, it measures or the number of times wherein it measures your collection period. Okay? The higher, the better. Meaning to say, you are effective in terms of your AR. Okay, after AR turnover, you have your AR collection period. How do we compute for AR collection period? Number of days, 65 man yan, 60 days man yan, divided by your account receivable turnover. What is AR collection? The number of days for it is, it is the number of days of your collection. Huh? The lower, the better. So in your Strava paper, what you will do is to explain each, particularly for your liquidity, your current ratio, asset investment yan, inventory turnover, inventory days, your AR turnover, and the AR collections. Now, hopefully, you are done already. Now, ba? Not yet, Carlo? Kunti na lang. Okay, very good. Alright. That's so far questions. Kira-kira naman, ang dami parang, there are a lot of ratios for liquidity, but ito lang naman yung ano. I want you to have this one and then to explain. This is the basic. No? Kasi meron pa tayong free cash flow. Huwag na. Okay. Yan lang na muna. Cash na so far.